To begin our search for peer-reviewed articles, let's use the database Academic Search Premier, which includes articles from many subject areas. You can search most of the library's databases at once, using the library search bar. However, searching databases individually allows you to use more advanced search techniques. Click the name of the database to see more information about it. And click Connect to open the database. If you're off campus, this is when you'll be prompted to enter your SFU computing ID. Welcome to Academic Search Premier. You can already see that there's more potential here for searching. Let's try a search on climate change again. That gave us fewer results than via library search, but it's still an awful lot. Let's try some advanced search techniques. First, let's add quotation marks around the terms we're searching. This lets the database know to search for these two words together as a phrase, rather than finding each word individually. That took our number of results down quite a bit. However, there's another popular term used for this topic. Global warming. We want to capture all of the articles that discuss the topic using each of these different terms. Okay, so that really made the number of results jump a bit. To get a more manageable set of search results, we're going to have to be more specific about what we're looking for. In other words, we have to narrow down our topic. Maybe we can focus on the impact of climate change on cities. We can also specify a geographic region, like North America. I've used the asterisk or star symbol at the end of Canada so that we'll retrieve variations of this word, including Canadian, likewise for North America. You might recall from a previous module that this advanced search technique is called truncation. That's still a lot of results to look through. We may want to narrow our results to articles that include climate change or global warming as subject headings. Subject headings are tags that summarize the key concepts of an article. If climate change is one of the subject headings for an article, you know the article is really about climate change. It's not just a minor phrase that turns up in the abstract. When we run this search, we see our number of results drop dramatically, and we can still limit our search to scholarly articles and narrow our publication dates. To view more information about an article, click on the title. This lets you see all of the information related to the article, including the bibliographic information that you're going to need to cite the article, the subject headings, and the abstract, which summarizes the article. These are all the places where your keywords can turn up. To access the full text of an article, look for the icons and links at the bottom of each record. Sometimes, instead of seeing a link to the full text, you might see a link that says, "Where can I get this?" This means that the article is not available as full text in this database, but Clicking on the link will take you to a new page, which will help you find the article elsewhere at SFU. The article might be available in a database, or it could be on a shelf in the library. If the library doesn't have a copy, you can click on the link Search Other Libraries and request a copy via interlibrary loan. As you search, you can add relevant articles to a folder and then email them to yourself. And remember, help is always just a click away.